is out here, man.
I had no idea.
Yeah. All comes back around.
Yeah, the PM Sonic, dude. Yeah, he was actually pretty good at PM, too. So let's see how his Ken's able to hold up against Pikachu, which, if you ask me, is probably one of his worst matchups. You got so many ways to get abused off the stage, and your focus broken from forward air and back air and neutral air. And just really easy combo food, too, due to your weight, fall speed, character model.
Yeah, your Lanny is always jeopardized by this character, and this is a lot of, like, kind of a litmus test in a way for, like, are you good against Pikachu? Okay, you're probably not on the top tier.
Yeah, probably not. But, I mean, I don't know, man. Pikachu making a solid case for potentially being the best character right in this game. Very close behind Joker, I'd say. But very underplayed, too. So matchup experience in short supply for a character like this.
Yeah, we saw Captain L using these Thunder Jolts, and he did dash check right after because he was hoping for a spot dodge because T-Jolt kind of puts you in this in a block mix-up and whatnot. So we're going to see a lot more of that throughout the set.
Now, the one thing that Ken does have over Pikachu is that he out-damages him significantly, right? So if they're trading hits at all, you're going to see Pikachu's percent go up by, like, 15 or 20, and then Ken's go up by, like, 1.
Right.
Literally on a multi-hit. So we'll see if that comes into play. I mean, it has been so far. Oh, and you got to keep your shield up. That's a two-hit move, my guy.
That's an overhead.
Yeah, it is, yeah. Except you don't have to block it high, fortunately. That would be so infuriating if you had to, like, angle your shield up against their aerials and the overheads.
I mean, sometimes this game you do. You have to angle it up against or you get shield poked,
but you
right?
know what I mean. Like,
yeah, I know what you mean. Yeah.
Oh, and the dunks from Captain L. All right. Sends Ghoulie to hell, and we've got an even match here. All right, Captain L fights his way on. Attack cancel bear. Another one.
It's a dash attack. This is some good damage right there.
Great combo. And a corner carry, too. Going to keep him stuck with his back to the edge. Yeah, so off stage, this is where things get really ugly
Jab
for Ken.
Block, okay.
Ooh, I like that, though. Instead of going for a smash attack, go for down tilt, dash attack. Keep your kill moves fresh, even though dash attack's one of them.
Yeah, he even used down tilt, which can send to another tech chase. You might be able to get a reset.
Right. Captain L killing it so far in the second stock. Up throw, thunder never works in this game, if I'm not mistaken.
It's frame perfect.
Is it?
Yeah, it's apparently frame perfect. So you'll see Pikachu's kind of use it as more of a read situation.
Right. Yeah, Pichu, on the other hand, he could just do it. Ooh, the regular get up to roll, throwing Captain L off a little bit, but no way are you living that. Pikachu's nair to down smash, one of his best kill confirms.
Yeah, if I say there was some consistency, it is that. It is nair dragged down into imagination.
Yeah, literally anything you want. If you can dream it, you can do it. And, man, even though Ken has a Shoryuken, I feel like his out-of-shield game is lacking, especially against a character like Pikachu, who's so tiny, he gets under the short hop aerials out of shield in many of his lag animations.
All right, Captain L getting out of the way, does not want to get poked again.
Ooh, the full hot bear and the Thunder Jolt. I mean, at this point, Captain L's just playing Akuma, man. Just
right.
Shoot the fireball at the 45s, zone him, chill, and get what comes to you.
Oh, no.
Oh, he saved him.
Saved him.
He did, for sure. Probably overestimating Ken's recovery a little bit there.
Yeah, I would say you didn't have to approach Ken in this situation, too. You know, Pikachu's camp game is so good, and I think it's really, really good against Ken and Ryu.
Absolutely. Characters that really struggle to get in against anybody. So even a projectile that's not too polarizing, like Pikachu isn't insane. Whoa! Okay, that was so good.
That was like almost Shades of Smash 4.
It was a shield grab fake out.
Yeah.
It's like, do a move that doesn't have a ton of range, make it ambiguous if they're going to be able to shield grab you, and then throw the forward smash when they can't and they try.
Yeah, honestly, like, people think you can shield grab a lot of things in this game, and I think the safe bet is the kind of what I kind of like to call triangle jumping. Like, you end up taking an aerial on block, and you should kind of, like, you know, jump backwards and whatnot, and you're kind of doing, like, this triangle motion back and forth,
right?
Putting yourself in, like, check situations.
Yeah, exactly. Like, instead of punishing with a move, you punish with positioning,
right?
Which is why, like, you know, something safe hits your shield. Okay, maybe just roll. You know what I'm saying? Maybe just get out of the way, because if you know you can't punish it and you might get swung on again for trying, then. It's better to just take the optimal positioning or better positioning from where you were. But of course, that wasn't the case there. Ghoulie taking the bait, gonna attempt the shield grab and die for it. Captain L really turning it up after really just the first few seconds of the match where Ghoulie was on fire.
Ooh, I see Palu on the board now.
Yeah. Interesting. Okay, so Captain L busting out a non-Pokemon slash Kirby character.
You might see it here first. I'm not sure how much he's really brought it out. But he does love buttons, and this character has it, and blows it up, too, with the shield.
Yes, she is very anti-buttons and a great pick against the Shotos in general. I mean, rips through focus attack with many moves, zones them out, edge guards them, combos them. I think probably their hardest matchup would be Paulo.
Yeah, I would definitely say. And
or Pika.
Or Pika, but you know, we do have Nair also being kind of a corner carry tool, just like Pikachu, so I can kind of see where his head's at in a way.
Yeah, absolutely. Oh, okay, unsafe Nair there.
All right, Ghoulie was kind of trying to scout the jump out of Tatsu. A lot of people do that.
Honestly, if I'm Ghoulie, I'm kind of relieved to see Paulo instead of Pikachu, because even if it's a worse matchup, which it's probably about the same, Paulo experience is readily available anywhere, and he probably knows this matchup a lot better.
Yeah, I would definitely say that's probably true. Also, the fact that Paulo's taller.
I was literally going to say that next. Yeah, the fact that she doesn't avoid your moves by existing is really good. Okay, Ghoulie taking the first stock here, showing his chops, man, saying, you know what? I was a little unfamiliar against Pikachu. Some weird stuff was happening, but like, if you let me play my game, pretty nice.
Yeah, I'm a little surprised that Captain Del kind of switched. I think it was he was getting stressed out by playing Pikachu, so he kind of wants to just sit back and, you know, do Paulo things.
Uh-huh. Yeah, she's a much less execution-heavy character.
Ooh, focus through the down throw raw bear.
Using Tatsu to infiltrate there. Oh, and
that's it.
No, it's not. Great DI there from Captain L, yeah. Ken's upbeat, or his Shoryu is honestly kind of fraudulent. It doesn't kill that early with great DI. And you can escape it with super great SDI. But still, holding onto a really solid lead here. Paulo bleeding out. She's gone to the next tilt to Shoryu. Oh, no, the miss input, though.
She's just chasing him down here. Here comes Ken.
Okay. And toss it back to the edge. And Captain L, man, doing a great job holding his advantage state. Counter is low-key really good against the Shotos at the edge because they won't, or Ken has difficulty snapping.
Yeah, you'll definitely see that come into fruition, I believe, throughout the match.
Yeah, if we see a game three, which is very possible at this point, and Captain L stays Paulo, that will probably be a factor.
And there we see Ghoulie picking up the stock with the Tatsu, and Captain L didn't text. He was able to short DP.
Ah, the bravery there from Captain L. He knew that focus was coming.
Yeah, we're even now.
All right, dead even game here. Ooh, Ghoulie getting the first opening, but didn't believe that his, I think Nair was going to connect, so he spot dodged right after it.
Monster really surprised he was down there doing down tilt, and the turnaround mechanic didn't come out fast enough through the roll, but I think that just, like, balanced in a way, right?
Yeah, it bugs out in certain situations. Some things will cross them up and just kind of screw them over because the players aren't thinking about trying to hold in, you know? It's like, oh, my broken mechanic will do it for me. Wow, Ghoulie swinging a forward smash the wrong way. I can't help but feel like that wasn't intentional.
What do you wanted, yeah.
Though I also can't fathom what it would have been. Oh, man, the chase down is so real. But Captain L, as you said, man, one of the most patient, passive players in the game. This guy is not afraid to run away from you. Uh-oh, back air.
Oh, yep. That is it.
You hate to see it. Ken, due to his weight, just so comboable. And, you know, that back air, down throw back air, is still going to be valid throughout the window that it'll actually kill him.
Yeah, and I man, it was kind of getting rough there for a second.